This is the first video of our series, The Chemical Basis of Life. In this series, we will cover the basic concepts on which biochemistry is built, from types of bonds that form molecules, to the physicochemical properties of the crucial components that form the biological systems. In this video, we will cover the types of bonds that make atoms combine to form molecules. As we have already discussed the atomic structure and orbitals, and the molecular orbital theory in previous videos, the links will be kept in the description box. Life starts with tiny things called atoms. These little guys are like the building blocks of everything. They decide what things are made of, how they interact, and how they behave. Atoms team up to make small groups called molecules. These molecules join together to create big and complex structures like proteins, which are like the worker bees inside cells. But considering the bonds that link the atoms together, we can classify them into covalent and non-covalent bonds. Number 1. Covalent bonds. In a molecule, atoms stick together using covalent bonds where they share pairs of electrons. For an atom to be stable, it wants a full outer electron shell. Helium achieved this with 2 electrons, while others, like oxygen, need 8. So, an oxygen atom, having 6 outer shell electrons, joins with 2 hydrogen atoms to make water. In a covalent bond, these atoms share electrons. Each atom contributes an electron or more to the shared pool. By doing this, both atoms end up with a more complete set of electrons, making them feel happy and stable. By sharing more electron pairs, they make double or triple bonds, affecting how molecules look. For example, molecules show in oxygen O2 double covalent bonds. It is important to notice that when atoms connect with covalent bonds, energy is released, but breaking the bond later needs energy input. Number 2. Non-covalent bonds. Covalent bonds are strong connections between atoms in a molecule. However, interactions between molecules or different parts of large biological molecules involve weaker linkages known as non-covalent bonds. Unlike covalent bonds, non-covalent bonds don't rely on shared electrons but on attractive forces between oppositely charged atoms. Each non-covalent bond is individually weak, about 1 to 5 kilocalories per mole, making them easily breakable and reformable. This characteristic allows non-covalent bonds to facilitate dynamic interactions among molecules in the cell, a crucial aspect of biological processes. Although each non-covalent bond is weak on its own, when numerous bonds work together, such as in DNA strands or different parts of large proteins, their collective attractive forces add up. This cumulative effect provides considerable stability to the overall structure. In this video, we'll explore various types of non-covalent bonds that play important roles in cellular activities. First, ionic bonds. Ionic bonds are attractions between charged atoms. In table salt, for instance, positively charged sodium and negatively charged chlorine. In this case, ions are held together by these electrostatic attractions. This bond is known as an ionic bond or salt bridge. While ionic bonds within a salt crystal can be strong, when salt dissolves in water, individual ions are surrounded by water molecules, preventing them from forming strong ionic bonds. In cells where water is abundant, bonds between free ions are not very important. However, weak ionic bonds between oppositely charged groups in large biological molecules play a significant role. For instance, in DNA, negatively charged phosphate groups are attracted to positively charged groups on a protein surface, and ionic bonds help hold the complex together. Although ionic bonds in cells are generally weak, about 3 kilocalories per mole, due to the presence of water, they can be stronger in the inner regions of proteins where water is excluded. Second, hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bonds happen when a hydrogen atom is linked to an electronegative atom like oxygen or nitrogen. In this case, hydrogen shared electrons hang out more with the oxygen or nitrogen, leaving the hydrogen with a slight positive charge. This positive hydrogen can then attract the unshared electrons of another oxygen or nitrogen, making a weak but important hydrogen bond. These bonds are like tiny connections and are common in molecules that have a positive and negative side like water. In big molecules like DNA, these hydrogen bonds help hold things together, making structures stable. Even though each bond is weak, when many of them work together, they become strong. But the cool thing is, when needed, these bonds can be easily loosened to let enzymes do their jobs. Third, hydrophobic interactions. Some molecules like sugars and amino acids love to hang out with water, so we call them water-loving or hydrophilic. On the other hand, molecules like fats and steroids don't really get along with water. They're water-fearing or hydrophobic. Hydrophobic interaction is like when these molecules try to avoid water. When these molecules are put in water, they tend to stick together to minimize their contact with water. This behavior happens because water molecules like to stick to each other and form a sort of barrier that pushes the hydrophobic molecules away. That's why you might see droplets of oil or fat on the surface of the water. They're trying to get away from the water as much as possible. So, hydrophobic interactions are essentially molecules trying to stay dry in the presence of water. Fourth, van der Waals forces. Imagine you have two molecules hanging out next to each other. Even though they're not charged like magnets, they still attract each other a little bit. This attraction happens because electrons are always moving. Sometimes, by chance, more electrons gather on one side of a molecule, creating a temporary imbalance. This makes the molecule a bit like a tiny magnet for a moment. The neighboring molecule notices this tiny magnetic moment and adjusts its electrons a bit. So, now you have one molecule with a temporary magnetism, and the other responding to it. These temporary attractions between the molecules, caused by the movement of electrons and their momentary imbalances, are what we call van der Waals forces. That was everything for this video. Thank you for watching.